Well, The Daily Show, don't have to tell you, one of the most popular shows on TV.
Of course, delivering the news, kind of like we do here, with more than just a hint of humor, at least we attempt to. Its correspondents have some of the best jobs around, poking fun at just about whatever's in the headlines.
I wish we could tell the news this way. This is the way we wish we could tell it. But I'll just bring her. Well, let's show this first. They get to make over fun stuff, make fun of fun stuff, like when Tiger Woods, they said he should try and switch religions. Take a look at this.
Now, your basic Protestantism gives you the opportunity to be born again in Jesus, but is that really enough for someone like a Tiger Woods?
So you're saying he should go with something a little stronger, a little Catholicism, perhaps?
Well, Catholicism does have a very orderly soul cleansing system, your confessional, your communion, your Jamesons. And as for Tiger's sexual transgressions, I mean, the church has tolerated far worse. But actually, I was referring to becoming one of Jehovah's Witnesses. They not only offer a chance at redemption for everyone, but also a seat in heaven itself for 144,000 of their best top contributing members. The Church Fathers, Venus and Serena Williams, Prince. It's like Scientology for black people.
The law doing what?
Good stuff. Samantha Bee, she's there and now she's here with us. She's been one of the top contributors for the show and now she's penned a candid autobiography called I Know I Am, But What Are You?
That's it. How do you do that without laughing and having to do 5,000 takes?
On the show? The show? Well, I've got to tell you, it's, when you're working and you feel like you're gonna laugh and you blow it and then you have to do it like a million times.
Yeah.
It's not as funny the second time around. So we try hard not to laugh, but sometimes we do. It happens.
We should say that this isn't costume. You do have somebody with you. You are
We have multiple persons in this body. So, well, me and someone else, basically. But someone asked me the other day if it was fake. I was like,
oh,
wow,
really?
You know what? I'm a fake journalist. Yes. But I'm not that fake. Not everything about me is phony.
And we were talking about you just have to be so pleased the timing of this.
It's
because
wonderful.
It's summer, wonderful time to be.
You know, I can sweat from glands that I didn't even know existed.
Nice!
It's a real gift. It's rare.
We're getting to know each other here.
We are. Let's get
personal.
Speaking of the book, you had to get into, and I guess this was before, but it doesn't matter. It had room for the baby. You had to get into a bee suit.
I did. And you can see the expression on my face is very pleased.
Very happy. Did you know that the National Spelling Bee is going on not even 15 minutes from here in downtown D.C.?
I love spelling bees.
You would fit in.
I would. But I am an excellent speller.
Are you? Don't
test me out, but
we don't know any SAT words.
I don't either.
But I mentioned that because I was out there covering it yesterday, meeting all these bright children.
Oh, that's nice.
And
did any of them faint? They pass out in the most adorable ways.
No fainters yet.
Just so cute when they're unconscious and laying down.
God,
yeah,
it
gets me every time.
Smelling salt.
But there's protesters on the sidewalk outside of the hotel.
Oh, really?
In your bee suit. Did you know this?
I did not know that. I should go by.
You started a trend.
I am going to kick some A.
So tell us about the book, because this isn't your first one.
Well, it is my first one that I participated in solely by myself.
Oh, all right.
You know, so I've contributed to other books, but this is my book.
So no ghost writers.
No ghost writers on this one. This is pure me. So basically, if you don't like the book, you probably don't like me. You know, there's really no other way.
No gray area there.
There is really no room for ambiguity.
No in between. You talk about a lot of stuff in here about your
family. It's candid.
Family.
People, yes, yes.
Is your family happy with all that that's in there?
They are. You know, I have a family of narcissists. We love to be known. Actually, my family is very happy with it. Because even though they're kind of bananas, I'm bananas too, so it doesn't really matter. And they like it. They like the way that they've been portrayed. They don't have a problem with it. They're very true to themselves, and I think that's great. So,
what is your favorite part of this book?
That's an interesting question. People have different favorite parts. I think my favorite part, my mother is Wiccan. My mother is a white witch.
You're serious about this?
Yes. Huh?
What does that mean? How does that?
I really don't know what it means. I'm not entirely sure what it means. She seems to know, and she always has been. And there was a time in my life when I was very serious about religion and Catholicism. I was a little girl attending Catholic school, not because of my mother, God forbid. And she worked very hard to kind of try. She tried to pound the Catholic out of me by taking me to some Wiccan ceremonies.
Yeah, how did that work? Did the Catholic Church know about your witch at home?
No, I don't believe they did. I'm sure they would have sent some kind of plague to our home.
Kept it under
but
wraps.
But they kept it on the down low.
But so you share that intimate experience with the reader.
I do. It's
reader.
All meant to be. None of it is tragic. Perhaps tragicomic. That's what I was going for.
Well, you know, speaking of religion, did you read the part about having the crush on Jesus? Don't
right.
I have this right?
Yeah,
very
well, that's
interesting.
What my mother was so concerned about me. Because
forget
she,
Justin Bieber. How about JC?
Please. Do we not? All the little Catholic girls had a crush on Jesus. His beautiful blue eyes and his silky hair and his clean, fresh robes.
Clean, fresh robes.
Just
nice.
Thinking about him. It's so evocative.
Dangerous territory for me.
It is hard. Yeah,
there's guilt already.
I know, there's guilt.
This conversation.
He's
going
to have to leave right after this segment.
I'm very lapsed. I'll take you with me. Hold my hand. Let's go on a journey.
You know, speaking of your pregnancy and everything, how
oh,
are
yes.
you going to explain what you do to your children?
You know,
not that anything's wrong with it, but I mean, they might be confused. You're up there doing a newscast a little differently.
You know, we had a terrible, we have learned not to, because my eldest child is only 4, and we showed her a segment from the show once. We thought she was going to love it because we put her in it, and we thought, oh, she's going to love seeing herself as a little baby. And she wept. It was horrible.
Oh.
So I think, you know, we will save that for another time. But she did see me on TV the other day, and Jason said to her, did you like seeing Mommy on TV? And she was like, I prefer to see her in person.
Oh, wow.
I know. I prefer. She's sassy.
So poignant.
She scares me on television.
I prefer the real thing, Father.
Mommy.
That's how she said it.
Right.
She's 4. She's got her own mind.
She has her own thing to do. She's not impressed by what you do.
She's not impressed. I think she think, you know, when little kids have parents who do television, they just think that every parent does television.
Yeah. What does your mommy do?
What show is your mom on? What show is your dad on?
Puts the other kids in their place.
Well, the other children could honestly think that as well. They're like, I don't know what show she's on.
Dad.
I have no idea what my parents do.
It's in the works.
They go out. They come home.
Samantha, thanks for visiting us here in our wonderful living room.
Thank you for
having me. We
want
to mention you have a book signing today.
I have a book signing tomorrow.
Or tomorrow.
It said board. You know, I could
works.
Do one today. You know.
Oh, there it is.
Borders. Yeah.
Borders.
On
K Street.
Which sounds so official to me.
It is. Wait till you're there.
Watch
I know.
Out.
Oh, it's dangerous.
Real deal down there.
4 p.m. tomorrow at the Borders. Good to
yep.
meet you.
Good to meet you.
In.
Thank you for having me.
We have
me.
To
Thank
get you,
you
to sign this book because my producer, her
okay.
mother, heart you.
Oh, my
God. Her name's Marilyn, if you could sign it.
Marilyn.
As we go.
Yes, I got it. Okay.
Write her a cute
this.
Note.
I will.
All right, coming up.